In this video, I'm going to show you how I got rid of this terrible Jello footage from my DJI O4 Lite and ended up with this beautiful smooth footage using a combination of the new DJI O4 Lite camera case from Axis Flying and a few other tricks as well. So this is what I bought, which is a set of 4 ND filters and 2 camera cases. One of them is 14mm, which you can see here. When I say 14mm, that's the width of it for fitting into smaller drone housings. Not has a single screw on the side of it for using for a pivot. This is the 20mm version, which has 3 screw holes on the side. You can use a single pivot or you can use a 2-hole system like on the DJI O3 unit. Each of these camera cases comes with a sachet of thermal paste, which I didn't actually bother using, and they also come with packets of screws, tiny screws, which I used to fasten the case. For this whole set I paid about £30 from AliExpress. That would be around about $40 in the US if you can actually get this stuff from China these days. So let's have a quick look at these ND filters. We have a 4, 8, 16 and 32, and these can be used to help you to get some really nice smooth footage from your drone. And before we start taking anything apart, I'm going to show you the drone which I'm going to be working on. It's a little 2-inch frame that I got from AliExpress. It was about $6, which was an absolute bargain. I couldn't resist it. And I will put the spec on screen right now. And while that's there, I'm going to talk about the camera mount which is on there at the moment. It's a custom one that I built, which is 3D printed. I did the CAD myself. And the white parts that you can see are made of silicone from a moulding kit that I got off Amazon for £10. And we are going to see that again later when I make some new parts. So first of all, I'm going to show you some footage from the drone flying with the exact same setup that I've just showed you on the desk. That's using that red plastic mount that I 3D printed and the silicone inserts. And you'll see that there is some fine Jello, but also some quite heavy Jello, which you're about to see, I think, when I power up like this. There you go. Look how bad that is. And that's what I want to get rid of. But what I also want to do is use the ND filters, which I've already showed you, because they can help us get some really nice motion blur. So without further ado, let's start taking this drone apart. And first of all, I'm just going to get this antenna out of the way and move on to taking out all 4 of the screws that hold the top plate in place. 1, 2, 3, 4 of them like that. And then we can get it open and start having a look inside. Now it's probably a good time to mention as well that if you haven't noticed already, I do have a disability that affects my right hand. Well, it affects both hands actually, but the right hand is like a little fairground claw, has no dexterity, it's just good for grabbing things. But don't let it worry you, it doesn't really worry me, I'm used to it. So now we're inside, we can start taking this camera mount apart, and as I say, these are made from silicone, and that's the white part that you can see. The red part is 3D printed using some CAD that I did myself, and I'm going to come back to that because I'm going to make some new ones for this new mount. And now that that's all out of the way, we can have a look at the back of the original camera that's in there, because this is actually the second camera I've put into this drone. The first one I had a crash and the cable came undone from the O4 unit, so basically when I received the new one that I replaced it with, I put some hot glue on there, and you can see in the frame now that's the white stuff on the back of the camera. So here I'm just going to pop open the original DJI housing that comes with the O4 Air Lite, and then we are ready to start installing the new Axis Flying camera case. And that will fit together something like this. But I mentioned earlier that I'd put hot glue on the back of the camera, and that's preventing me here from closing the actual camera up. So I ended up having to find a pair of snips and start cutting away at the hot glue to remove it from the back of the camera. I didn't really make a very good job of filming this, but I was successful in the end and managed to remove all of the hot glue from the back of the camera strip. And that's allowed me to fit the camera into the case nice and snugly. Put the back in place. Open the tiny bag of screws that came with the camera case and start securing them down to the back of the case, which again I managed to film really badly. But here it is, all installed and ready to go back into the drone. Now I'm quickly measuring the distance between the camera mounting plates and also the width of the camera. As we know, it's 20mm, that's what's advertised when you buy it. Next step of the process is doing some CAD using Fusion 360. There are loads of tutorials out there if you want to learn how to do this sort of thing, but leave me a comment if you want me to do some videos about it as well. But I've taken the old frame that you saw in the video earlier and I've just basically modified it, making a two-hole mount with a rotation system built in. And here's a very quick 3D print, and I can start putting it all back together. And this is how it looks with everything fitted, ready to fly. And if you can hear that scratching, that's my dog walking about while I'm trying to record. So I'm almost ready to fly this, but first of all I'm going to put an ND filter in place. Pretty sure this is the ND16, it doesn't actually say on the filters, so I'm just assuming what it says, the order on the box from left to right. So the moment of truth, does it work? Does it get rid of the Jello? Does it give me smooth footage? Well, no. As you can see, there's quite a lot of heavy Jello when I put the power on and also when I try to corner like this. So I won't bore you with the rest of this video, I'll just show you that I've gone back to the drawing board and made some modifications, which have completely solved the problem. So here we go with some more CAD starting from the mounts that I showed you earlier, and here's some speeded up clips of me actually working on it. And what I've been aiming for is two silicone inserts that sit inside the plastic mounts. And to make the silicone mounts we need a mold, so that's what I'm making here in this speeded up clip. And the finished mold looks something like this. Now I can just 3D print that and mix up some silicone. So these are the finished 3D prints, two mounts and the mould, which I just pop off the board here. And this is the silicone kit. This was £10 from Amazon and gives you enough fluid to mix up quite a large amount of silicone mounts if you want to use this sort of system. You basically just mix equal amounts from the two bottles. I mixed up 2 grams, 1 gram of each of the two different solutions. Then you give it a really good stir and you can start pouring it into your mold. And once again, I made a really bad job of filming this. Then you leave it for 4 hours to set. I ended up leaving it overnight because I did this in the evening, and in the morning they were ready. If you do have the time to learn how to do CAD and 3D printing, I do recommend this system for making silicone mounts. I've had a lot of success with it in the past. And here you go, this is me just peeling them out of the mold in the morning. Then I've just cleaned them up with a scalpel to get rid of any excess solution that had seeped out of the side of the mold. And this is what the finished article looks like close up. And so now we do some very, very rapid reassembly. I can assure you it took me a huge amount longer than this, because obviously with my hands I can make anything look really awkward, and it took me a couple of goes to get it all working and everything put in place with the silicone mounts. But as you can see, as I slow this back down to normal speed, this is what it looks like with the silicone mounts set into the 3D printed mount. And in a moment, we're going to find out the moment of truth whether this has actually worked. So here we go. This is a 3D printed mount with silicone inserts, and the O4 Lite camera is mounted in the Axis Flying DJI O4 20mm camera case. And as you can see, there is absolutely not a sausage. No Jello whatsoever. I've also got on there an ND16, and the camera is set. This is slightly overexposed actually. I probably should have put the ND32 on there because the sky, as you can see, is burnt out slightly. But the camera is set to completely manual. I've got it on 4K 60 frames per second, and the shutter is set at 1/60th for playback at 30 frames per second. And as you can see, if I pause it very briefly when I fly low over this grass, you should see there's some nice motion blur. And there's no Jello even when I power loop it like this. And to be honest with you, I'm really, really happy with the result, and I would highly recommend using some of this system if you want to try and get the same results. I will be linking the CAD files below in the comments if you want to download them and try it for yourself with the silicone mounts. Other than that, happy flying, and I'm going to leave the rest of this video to play out with some music.